The first type of mechanism during the DNA sequencing is, so here whatever the genes which express their characters, identification of their nucleotide sequences, that means expressed tandem repeats, means the part or the genes which express their characters are sequenced, that is the first type. But in the second type, there is no discrimination of expressed or non-expressed, or coding or non-coding. So this is nothing but second sequence. Second type of sequencing, what happened? They are continuously sequencing the genes or nucleotides. They are continuously sequencing nucleotides, nitrogen bases, whether they are belonging to the coding or non-coding, no problem. So total nucleotides are sequenced. So what are sequenced here? Total nucleotides are sequenced. Whereas in the first type, only coding part of the sequence is developed. Okay. Next, if you see, the important DNA sequencing method was developed by Frederick Sanger. So here generally this Sanger used two types of DNA probes for the sequencing of the DNA. So the DNA probes are YAC and BAC. So YAC and BAC. So YAC. What is a YAC? Yeast artificial chromosome. That is called as YAC. So if you take BAC, bacterial artificial chromosomes. So these artificial chromosomes he had used for the sequence of the DNA. Actually, these are all radioactive probes. For example, if some sequences are here on the DNA. So these are some sequences like this. Okay. So T A G C. So these are some sequences. If we use radioactive probes, so these radioactive probes are pairs. They pair with the complementary pairs with the nitrogen bases. A pair with thymine, T pair with adenine, G pair with cytosine, C pair with guanine, T pairs with adenine, adenine pairs with thymine, thymine pairs with adenine, guanine pairs with cytosine, cytosine pairs with guanine. So these are the complementary base pairs. These are produced artificially, and all of these are radioactive substances. So radioactive substances can be easily observed under the microscope or photographic plate illuminator. So this is Sanger's method. Sir, after that, the development of computer, as well as different types of tools, helped for the different types of shotgun sequencing method. So this shotgun sequencing method is the advanced method of DNA sequencing, in which the improved tools are utilized. Computer is utilized for the sequencing of the DNA, as well as recording of the data, as well as analysis of the data. Okay, so here these are the two types of methods. Sanger method is there. In the Sanger method, by the PCR method, amplification of the DNA, number of DNA copies are produced. These copies are hybridized with the YAC and BAC. Then what happened? These radioactive probes, hybrids, will attach to the complementary to the DNA, which is unknown. Then you can identify the sequences of the nitrogen bases in the DNA. Okay, so this is DNA sequencing method. Let us see what are the salient features of the Human Genome Project. What Human Genome Projects had revealed? So salient features of HGP. HGP in the sense what? Human Genome Project. So first point. Sir, here in the first point, there are 46 chromosomes are present in the human genome. How many chromosomes are present in the human genome? 46. Next, 30,000 genes are sequenced. How many? 30,000 genes are identified. Next, 3 billion nucleotides identified. How many? 3 billion nucleotides identified. So next here, generally only 50% of the genes are expressing their characters. 50% of the genes are expressing their characters. So 50% of the genes with unknown function. We cannot say they are not expressing any character. 50% of the genes with unknown function. Okay. So this is about 50%. Next, if you see, only 2% of the DNA is coding DNA. How much? 2% of the DNA is coding DNA. 2% of the DNA is coding DNA. Okay, na? Next. So 99% of the genome of all the individual is same. 99% of the all the individual's DNA is same. There are some differences in the nucleotide sequences in individual. So I can say 99% is same, but no two individuals have similar genome. No similar individuals have similar genome. Okay, sir, you are saying 99% is same, only 1% is less. So that 1% is more than enough to bring the difference between the two individuals. So 99% is similar, only 1% is different. So that 1% is unique. Unique means what? They are different from person to person. So one person will have that sequences. Another person will not have that. So that is individual difference in that 1% only. So as per this human genome project, they identified that chromosome number 1 is the biggest chromosome. Number 1 chromosome is the biggest chromosome, as it has 2968 genes. 2968 genes are present in the chromosome number 1. Okay, sir, each gene has 3000 averagely. Each gene has averagely, it has 3000 nucleotides. How many nucleotides are there for each gene averagely? So each gene has 3000 nucleotide sequences average. Okay, so next, chromosome number 1 has how many genes? 2968 genes. So that is next. Shortest chromosome is the Y chromosome. Shortest chromosome is the Y chromosome. Y chromosome has 231 genes. How many genes are present on the Y chromosome? 231. Next, the biggest gene is dystrophin gene. What is the biggest gene in the human genome? Dystrophin. Dystrophin is a gene which produces dystrophin protein, which is responsible for the muscles formation as well as the formation of sarcolemma. So dystrophin is the biggest gene. How you are considering it is the biggest gene? It has more number of nucleotides. If a gene has more number of nucleotides, it can be called as big gene. So dystrophin has more number of genes, so then it is called as biggest gene. Okay, na? So these are the salient features of the human genome project. So 46 chromosomes, 30,000 genes, 3 billion nucleotides sequenced, 50% genes are expressed with the characters, 50% genes are with unknown function, 2% DNA is coding DNA, remaining 98% of the DNA is junk DNA. So 99% of the genome is similar in all individuals, only 1% is different. And if you take chromosomal number 1 is the biggest chromosome, it has 2968 genes, and averagely each gene may have 3000 nucleotide sequences. And if you take shortest chromosome is the Y chromosome, it has only 231 genes, and the biggest gene in the genome is dystrophin, which is responsible for the formation of muscles in the individuals. So this is about salient features of human genome project. Means what human genome project had released or revealed outside regarding the human genome characters. Okay, let us see what are the applications of human genome project.